Hello, welcome to Restless Driver, Season 1, Episode 3, October 29th, 2014. Sanya, you're back. I don't know why. No, I'm just kidding. I know why. I had a race with some friends who could type, I will do it, with a specific format, you know, very formal, correct, etc. So I'm going to say hi to everyone. Don't advertise your channel again.
Hello, I am SanyoGaming.
Whatever.
And the reason I won is because I was typing on a keyboard.
A Myers would have won, and he said, ha, gay, gay. Like, he put in an extra G by accident. Alright, you already saw the car. There she is. It's an Alteza AS200 1998. I got it right on this day. Woohoo! Also, I found a day where I didn't have that much homework. Woohoo! Actually, I don't have any.
And so, I'm driving the Mazda Enza 07.
Alright, let's not accidentally cancel out the face cam again. I tried to do the PowerPoint that I'm going to use for this video. You know, that has all my notes and stuff, so I don't forget the information. I'm going to start doing that. As you can see, there it is. Yeah, that's all the information. I'll just switch the page and boom, I got all my information right there. So I can get you guys a more detailed show. And today, instead of having the full screen monitor to show what this camera sees, it's on this side because the other half is being used for the PowerPoint. So that's why I'm looking off to the side a little bit more today. Just go ahead and get that out of the way, you know, all the useless stuff. Do that in the beginning so you got the rest of the film to actually do the show. Alright, let's try not to screw up this time. Alright, so this thing has 157 horsepower, 367 performance points, FR, right, here's a key factor. It has 1,305 kilograms. Right? Just pay attention to that. I'll repeat later on in the show because we got another car. You're going to be shocked. Kind of. And it's naturally. This car is actually naturally aspirated. This car has a 4-speed. I should put the transmit, like how many gears each car has. See, look, I'm in 4th again, and I can't shift up. Oh, sorry. I'll wait for you.
Hey, I thought the front wheel drive would have done that.
Oh, it would? Alright. Die! Alright.
No, I'm in the front wheel drive.
No, I know that. How can you drift a front-wheel drive car?
You can't.
Actually, you kinda could. All you gotta do is somehow get the back end loose. And then...
Oh yeah, I did that with my Prius.
Alright, stupid Priuses. No offense, probably half America has a Prius, because they're trying to go economical. And that's all the...
Not really, you're just killing your Earth.
Well, yeah, because you have to use so much gas just to get it built.
Like, you have to mine nickel, too.
That's a lot of work.
As you see, this thing has 10 more horsepower, and that's why I'm pulling away.
You have 167?
Yes. And this weighs just as much as that.
1305?
It weighs about like 1350, but that's because it's got a bigger engine.
Huh, interesting.
It's good. Yeah, this has a 2.6 liter Mazda 4-cylinder.
Don't say VTEC. I keep hearing that, like, majestic, and surprisingly and sadly, I keep hearing the word Ebola. I cannot stand that word for some reason.
Especially that someone in Pennsylvania has it. Yeah.
You do realize this is going on in public, you know, not private or unlisted.
I know. I know why.
Pedophiles could be viewing this.
Controversies aside, these are brilliant cars.
Sure.
These
yeah, I mean, you know, it's got a decent looking interior, you know, black. It's standard.
See, this one has a real interior, and it's actually really nice. It's the standard Mazda steering wheel and stuff. It's basically got every option that you can get.
Is it me, or did my car ghost when I hit the pause button?
Yeah, in the new update they put that.
We're on 1.13, right?
1.13, we're on like 1.15.
1.17 is for Grand Theft Auto 5. This is 1.13.
Oh, yeah. Oh, yeah, I'm confused. Sorry. Yeah, it's like 1.13 or 4.
I should say I'm correct.
Okay, TK's always right because this is his channel.
Sure. I'm not always right.
Thank you. I'm not either. So, are we done viewing
me? Hold on. I want to pull out your car and show them the interior. I have your car. It's kind of tuned up and stuff. Let me find it. Where the heck is it?
Show the Mazda.
Now, I'm going to sort through my huge list. One day, I will have covered every single car on here.
Okay, I'm about to set my fast lap, and I didn't make it. Okay, my fast lap is a 109, I guess.
Okay, yeah, Mazda would be really helpful. Probably, actually, you know what? Next time you need to think about what you say, because you gotta remember, I have all 35 Mazda, Miatas.
I know.
So I have 41 to look through.
It doesn't say you see It doesn't matter that I live in Pennsylvania.
Huh?
It doesn't matter that I live in Pennsylvania.
Pennsylvania
is huge.
True. Alright, so this thing does have a 6-speed.
Yep.
It's actually got an okay-looking interior. I mean, there it is, right there. That's Sonya's car. Alright. I had to put a big wing on it, I know. But it's supposed to look like a sporty Ricer. Okay, maybe not a Ricer. I don't like to use that word. Does it just feel
like... It's like more like Dad's car racer. That's the way it is.
He's a horn.
It's just a nice, sensible Japanese car.
Oh, by the way, I just want to point that out. See this line right here, this white line? On my screen, that's actually normal. I don't even know why. Do you have a white, like, line on the right side of your screen?
What, for me?
Yeah.
No.
No? Well, this is the only video game it does it on, anyways.
Once again, my channel is SanyoGaming.
I'll leave a link in the comments. Or the description, one of the two.
I'm even popular enough now.
Actually, I don't really use the comments.
I'm even popular enough now if you look me up on Google, it actually is the first thing that comes up.
Oh, same here. www.youtube.com/user/RacermanXtreme. I don't even know why they have to put user. Just do youtube.com/RacermanXtreme.
Yeah,
One day they'll send out an update and let everyone fix it. Yeah, I mean, you got a clock, you got a basic radio, you got your hazard lights right by the air vents, so...
You even got one of those new fancy starter things that isn't actually, like, it's keyless, basically.
Wait a minute, that's a GPS. I thought that was just a normal radio.
That's a GPS, because it's the sport model, this is the nice one.
Gran Turismo would have to do it. Alright, well, let's quit wasting our time on the good car, and let's get to a better car. Alright, next in our PowerPoint / show, right, I already know what's next. Pull out your competitor for the car that you wanted to drive, but I said, ha, no.
Okay.
Ha 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 ha.
You insist. Which might come as a surprise to you, but this is just a
fact. Oh yeah, I forgot. It's a Ford. It's another Ford. It's from
1998.
I have to say, I mean, I hate the Mustangs, ranging from 1972 to 2014. The 2015 is the best one I've seen since 1971. Like since the 1971 model.
That's an insult to that car, because I love that car.
But this car is rewriting the performance in a way.
The thing
with 775 horsepower, of course, tuned. And 581 performance points tuned. I have an FR drivetrain. Horrible suspension as usual. It's actually supercharged aspiration right now. Of course, because it's tuned. If I have weight reductions on it, I don't.
No matter what.
I don't know. Oh. Well, I have the supercharger on it as well. Like the upgraded.
Basically, with this car is what I'm saying.
Wait a minute, that's not the right one.
Yes, it is. If
you're pulling out the Taurus, remember?
No, I am not. I pulled out this.
He's describing a Ford Taurus, and that's what he pulls out.
See, my point is, if you buy a really cheap car instead of going for an expensive one and just tune it for spending the same money, it can naturally be better.
Here, back up to the wall. Because I have my foot on the clutch.
Okay, when we go home?
25. 21? No, I'm just kidding. 25. Come on, shift. That was a shift fault.
I had a bad launch, so it doesn't matter.
Alright, hold on, let's drag race, but this time I'm using my paddle shifters and I won't screw up.
Okay,
it is possible to make a gear change as fast as a paddle shifter change. You just gotta do it really fast. And you gotta be ready to shift it. But I didn't take my foot all the way off the gas. Because Gran Turismo is really picky. Like, let's say this is your gas right here. You have to go like that to do it. But in, other video games, I just do that and shift at this, when I'm pushing it down and stuff. So this game's really picky. Come on.
Basically, what I'm saying is that you can get a Honda and tune it for as much as you can get that to get that stock. And I'm saying this will be better. Might be a little noisy in the interior because of the VTEC. But it's actually really nice. It's got four seats and like that. It has good fuel economy. And it's an everyday car that's not harsh and and bad on normal roads. It's just a sensible, fast car. Also, since it doesn't have rear wheel drive, you don't go sliding around everywhere.
Alright, let's go on, zero.
Double zero.
Got it that time.
You might have won there, but that's for that V8 tour.
And the better gear shifts. Like, I put, like I used the paddle shifter, so it would disable the clutch, like, the need to hold it down. But then, as soon, like when I shifted to second, I engaged the clutch. Because with the G27, if you pull back a paddle shifter, the clutch is no longer necessary. But once you push that clutch in, until you pull back a shifter, it's mandatory to use the clutch.
And the thing about this Honda is, this is the Integra. This is the really nice one. So this comes with the leather.
Alright, this car's kind of fun. Alright, let's point the camera at the alarm clock up there. Let's see, 547. Yeah, that's the kind of time. Where'd it go? Just saw it, but I know I didn't.
What
do
you miss?
Yeah, remember the funny car that we just have to do because it's just awesome like that? Hold on, don't say it. Okay. It's that really small car. Smaller than a roadster. And they were born to be from Japan. Alright, let's...
These are both roadsters.
I know you just saw it. We're gonna review the cappuccino. Alright, let's see how good this thing is. Yeah, we're driving our little paint cars.
Except for, I have a better one. Hey, what are you doing?
Getting
in my way.
Ha ha! Sarah! Wow, the Sarah sucks.
No, it doesn't. The Toyota Sarah is a very nice car.
Now, mainly because I hate the name. Sarah.
Name aside, this is a really nice car. It's...
Okay, I'm just kidding. I don't hate the name.
Although it's only a two-seater.
There's a certain someone out there that I absolutely hate that shares similar name. No reference to her.
Yep. But this car actually comes really, like, it's really nice. It comes with golden doors.
Gold?
No, Goldwing.
I thought you said gold, and I was like, what kind of guy car is that? But yeah, you see, this thing has a drop top, so...
Actually, no, that's a hard top.
Well, it's a drop top. It goes away. It folds back. It's a hardtop convertible.
But this has, of course, has a glass roof. It has dual exhausts. Very low to the ground. Front wheel drive. Still, it's a little three cylinder. That's amazing. I love the engine. And also, with 100 shot of nitrous, this thing has an estimated horsepower of 600 when you hit the nose.
Okay, so I'm going to read you the stats. 174 horsepower, 42 performance points. FR, it's the, I mean, all the cars we've reviewed, that, or actually I have, are FR. All of his are FF.
Yes.
622 kilograms turbo. Aspiration. Oh, by the way, wait, do you have NOS on that?
Yes, 100 shot of NOS.
See ya. Wait! Okay, well, mine's gonna last way longer.
I wasn't using NOS.
What? You weren't using NOS. You're kidding.
No. Because this car makes 280 horsepower without NOS.
What the? Okay,
it costs just as much as a cappuccino.
Just as much?
Yep.
Impossible.
Also, it has a little spoiler on the back that keeps it from ever sliding. As you guys may not know on this DK's channel, I have actually raced. I have raced an FXX in this era and beaten them on Nürburgring.
You race a Ferrari FXX and beat it?
Driven by a Mappy 418.
Okay, Mappy, you just lost like 10 subscribers. Nobody wants to see you fail to a Sarah.
I think I might upload that video too. I still have it.
Do it.
I also have the one that I was in a Mini Cooper, he was in an MR2, and his friend Jerk was on a Honda Civic EV, and I won.
Yeah, Jerk's is cool. Wait, I'm just wondering, Jerk subscribed to my channel, or is he only on Mappy?
I guess he's only on Mappy. He didn't subscribe to me. No one does. I only have 13.
I remember when I had 13.
Which I'm about to get 14 because my friend's making a new account.
Ooh, tell him to add me as well.
Nah, he doesn't like you.
You kidding?
Well, you don't know him. He's my friend from real life.
Well, tell him to subscribe to my channel.
Also, if you didn't know, the Sarah revs all the way up to 10,000 RPMs.
Makes this thing will go up to 12. Hold on. Actually, no, my mine
times.
Goes to 10.
Look at my lap time.
You did that in the Sarah.
Yep.
53.682.
Actually, I'm gonna go for a hot lap right now. I'm not using any NOS.
I'm gonna go for a lap.
Oh, and guys, for your information, if you go and buy a Sarah, you cannot get this color in it. This is like the perfect color for it, but sorry, you can't get it. I'm pretty sure you need to go buy like an old Alphard or something, guys.
Whatever. Well, I bet the cappuccino would be a nice car for a lap.
I set another good lap.
Alright, well, I have the option at about right now to put in a video clip. It would be the Season 2 Concept Intro 1. If I'm going to put it in, it's going to be going in right now. Okay, it may or may not have gone in, but if you did see it, I'm going to review a car that is new to the intro. You've never seen it before. Are you done?
For me?
Yeah.
Yeah, one second. I'm gonna test up top speed of
this
here.
Oh, wait, no. We're going on Route X.
Okay. I wanna see the top speed of this when we get there.
Alright. Well, I'm not gonna spoil it. I want you to watch the video unless I've already put it in. So, if you saw the video, you already know what car I'm testing, because you've never seen it before. Until, like, the very end. But the... What?
Got your mouth on work?
No, I'm filming this.
Your mouth on work?
No.
What did you do on your thing?
I don't know. Crap, I'm not gonna have a sensor.
Purple applesauce, guys!
Purple applesauce. That cracks me up, dude. We're on the inside. Always more on the inside. Except on occasion. Alright, Route X. Come on.
The funny part is that the cappuccino is actually a lot newer than the Terra.
No, it's not. I was driving in 1991.
Hey.
People of YouTube, the stats for the Terra are 480 pp, 258 horsepower, 794 kilograms, 191 tons of torque, and it's got a 1.5 liter engine, and it's front wheel drive.
Alright, I'll be right back.
So now people, I am testing top speed of the Toyota Sierra.
Jeez, people don't know when I'm filming and when I'm not.
It's the same with
cut
me.
Out. What else do I have to cut out? The rest of the show? I don't think so. Alright, well,
right
how
now,
fast is
right,
it going then?
Right now, without nitrous, I am about to shift into fifth. I'm doing 175.
Nice.
Okay, I'm in sixth. Turbo is all the way down. Come on.
Alright, this car is an absolute monster.
Once I hit the top of the hill, I am going to slam on the nitrous. It's about 500 horsepower worth of nitrous right there. Okay, gonna hit it now. Okay, 200. 210. 220. 225.
And a Sarah.
230. People, this era is almost as fast as a McLaren F1. That is sad.
And here's the thing, it's time, but you gotta remember, Gran Turismo claims that they're really accurate, but they're probably not the most accurate.
Okay, the Sierra has hit 230.
And this Aston Martin 177 has a whopping 1,221 horsepower, 652 performance points, FR, 1,305 kilograms. You've heard that number before. It's the Altezza. It's got the exact same weight as a freaking supercar.
And people, the Sierra stops from 220 miles per hour to zero in about 6 seconds.
Supercharged aspiration. We're doing about 290 right now. That's where the 1,221 horsepower comes from. 300 miles an hour, roughly. And I'm using NOS right now. This car has gotten up to 330 in a draft and nitrous at the exact same time.
Okay,
Like, you have to fire simultaneously. Like, you have to draft and fire the NOS simultaneously.
Yeah? Is that so?
Yeah, but you're getting to do 300. I mean, this, I'm moving so freaking fast right now, but it just doesn't seem fast. I don't know, I think it's just Gran Turismo. I mean, a lot of games, you feel like you actually get somewhere. This game, however, when am I finally going to get there? No, you're just asking that the whole time. When am I finally going to get to the end of this road? When am I finally going to get back to the finish line and start the next lap? Because it just takes forever. It's just the way the game was made. It's okay, it's just that the other games, you actually feel like you did something. And you didn't have to.
Well, guys, I'm getting out a car that has the same... It's from the same year as that.
2011?
It was made in the same continent. And it has two more cylinders. Actually, no, does that have a V12?
I think it has a V12.
Oh, then it has two less cylinders.
So it's a V10.
Yes.
I was afraid of that.
And it's the very American and Italian Alfa Romeo TZ3 Stradale.
It looks like a Viper.
It is a Viper.
It's a Viper?
It's the European Viper, if you didn't know. Basically, Alfa Romeo made a version of the Viper. So, I figured I'd bring out a competitor for the Aston Martin 177, and here it is.
When am I finally going to get to the bed? I'm almost there. Actually, I'm going to throw out a surprise card just because I want to show that you can get a car for less than a million dollars that does around the same speed. Alright, I'm going to pull out the car real quick. There's actually two of them, and they're only a year apart.
I don't know what you're talking about. This car costs $600,000.
Yeah, I got something way cheaper. And if you tune it, it'll go a lot faster, if not the same speed.
And the tuning was $300,000, so it only cost $900,000.
Yeah, but here's the thing. I have my iPhone or something. No, wait, I don't have that text tone. I thought I heard a text tone, never mind. You see, this car is only $150,000, brand new. No anything on it. And it's watch what happens when I shift it to sixth gear and just step on the NOS. Watch where it goes. I'm only using the stock transmission.
It's the 4GT, isn't it?
That's what I'm driving. Yes. It's the 4GT. Look at this, alright? 180,
trust me,
185.
I'm
going
to catch up to you.
Look.
I'm already doing over 220.
I'm doing 290 in a 4GT, fully tuned. It's running 940. And if you remember, I actually gave this car a paint job. You've seen this car before. And you remember that I wanted to buy the 2005 a few months ago.
280. 285, no NOS.
302,
no
300.
Are you using NOS?
No, I actually ran out. But this thing was 287, no NOS.
Oh, dude, this thing wouldn't... I'm going uphill right now with no NOS doing faster than that.
290. Dude, 300. I'm just saying that if you want a cheap car that does about the same as that Alfa Romeo or that Aston Martin, just buy a 4GT or... Better yet, actually, I have another surprise.
You can't a Viper.
No. Not a Viper.
A Viper, you
we
can get
totally
all the speed
forgot
that you want.
About... The other car, the other competitor.
What?
You got the Viper, you got the 4GT, you know, it's got the wrong drivetrain.
The McLaren MP4.
It's American.
The Corvette.
Maybe. No, not the Hillbilly Construction Site pickup truck. Although that might be a competitor. Matt, we might be able to make it a competitor.
I can make it a competitor. So meet me at the start line, I'll see what it is.
Yeah, it's the C7. The brand new Corvette. It's not even $100,000. It's the cheapest car that does the same as all these other supercars.
I want to see if it can do the same as this.
It can, because it's got a wing on it.
It doesn't matter if it has a wing on it. It's actually going to help it, because the aerodynamics on those new ones are really good. And it would just keep it on the ground. It needs downforce, so you'd actually kind of help the car. So bring it down here.
Well, if you hear Mappy ever rambling on about how spoilers suck, he actually makes a point. It's drags the car.
Yeah, I know. It's drag. It's cold.
I like the front of it, but I'm still so disappointed in those Alfa Romeos. So disappointed. They seem like good cars. It's just that yuck. How can you say that's good?
These still have the same interior as the Viper too.
Yeah, I noticed that when I drove it one time.
The sound is also weird.
Stop.
Okay. Go ahead on 55.
Alright.
I'm not gonna use any knots whatsoever.
Same here. Better launch. I should have used knots.
I'm not using any knots and I'm pulling away. I'm already doing over 200.
See my thumbs, see my fingers. Only 240. Use the shift.
$260. $220. $280.
$230, and I'm starting to. Alright, sixth gear. $235.
$290.
Screw this. NOS. $245.
$250. Okay, I'm going downhill now. Over 300. 300.
Alright, going downhill. Yeah, let's pick up the speed.
305. I guess now I'm going to hit the off. 310. 315. Oh, 320.
I'm out of speed.
320.
Kind of NOS, whatever. Well... Alright, well, I'm gonna go ahead and get you the stats on those last two cars. Right, so...
And the TZ3 can... And the newer updates, it can turn. That's surprising. He used to not be able to turn. And it still... I'm wrong. It still can.
Why would they suddenly send out an update improving the one car's physics?
I don't know, they do that with a bunch of stuff.
Oh, remember, that's fully tuned with the stock transmission.
And now
don't bother tuning the C7. Sorry. Don't bother. Oh my god, stop. Stop it. No. No, Sonya. Bad Sonya. Bad. Bad boy. Alright.
I'm not a dog, you idiot.
Alright, this has 20 more horsepower, different drivetrain, different performance points. There you go. Now, you can talk.
Basically, if you're gonna go for speed, just buy this. But if you're gonna go for cheap, go for something American or Japanese. That's all I gotta say.
Alright, well, I'm gonna end the show pretty much with you driving a little bit. How many cutscenes do we want to do?
Okay. I'm just gonna use NOS.
I'm gonna somehow put one of these.
I remember we did this last video with the Viper.
Yeah, and now you're doing it with the European Viper.
I haven't even done it with my actual tuned Viper that I set up for.
Whoa, that I just did exactly what you see with the Aston Martin. I did like the exact same thing. Like I zoomed in when it blurs out and then I zoom out and like just replace. How about this? Have you seen the season 2 video?
Wait.
Sonia, have you seen the season 2 video?
Wait, look at the speed I'm hitting right now.
Info 315.
I hit 317 right there.
Sonia, remember how like with the Aston video, it's like far away, and then like I zoom in, it blurs, and then I zoom out,
okay,
and
okay,
off
I'm
goes
gonna,
to
I'm
Aston.
Gonna hit the bridge right here.
Sonia, I asked you a question.
Yeah, I heard you.
Well, did you see it?
Yeah.
I did the precisely exact same thing.
Did you see that? From 300 miles per hour, I hit the brakes and it stopped in 500 meters.
Wow.
A little bit more than a quarter mile. And what's up, episode about now?
Huh?
Because I'm at an loss.
What's in the episode?
Yep, because I'm at an loss.
So we were running at we were running on your NOS.
Yeah. Look at this. I'm doing
NOS anytime throughout the show.
Not really. That was the first time.
Okay, well you might have forgotten already.
I'm doing 60 miles per hour with brakes the wheel on.
Oh yeah, the Jaguar XFR is perfect for that. By the way, next week I might be reviewing the Jaguar XFR. Alright, let's go ahead and end on that bombshell. Alright.
Good night, everybody!
Oh, and last week, Sonia had to get off. Bye-bye, Sonia, you have to get off. No, I'm just kidding. Alright, well, we'll see you guys next time.
I'll see you on my channel.
Alright, and...